Greetings, everyone.
好，我们先测试一下这个逐步口译的感觉。
Now let's test the ability of the translator.
Not the ability. Just how the flow works. So, good afternoon, everyone. 我到底要讲错乱了，对不起。好，那个大家好，非常高兴就是今天有这个机会来 host 这个 forum 哦，那是由开放文化基金会跟法国在台协会共同举办。
Today it is my honor to host the forum organized by Open Culture Foundation and the office the French office in Taipei.
那我们今天的主题其实有两个部分哦，第一个其实是 Open Data 在整个地方政府的应用。
Today we have two themes. One is the application of open data in local government.
那再来其实是 open data 常被视为是要做数位治理、资料治理的前置作业。那下一步我们想要达到就是新的这个民主的形态的这样的讨论。
And next is open data using as the digital governance and the next level of democracy.
Okay.那我想我要讲什么？好，那开放文化基金会其实是台湾很多开放原始码的社群共同发起的一个法人组织。
And OCF Open Culture Foundation is actually a legal entity established by various open source community here in Taiwan.
那包含像是 G0V， 各位可能知道临时政府。那这几年因为在国际上就是对台湾做这个 CVTech 或者 Open Data 方面大家有蛮多的认识啊，那所以有很多国外的朋友会来台湾，那就由 OCF 这边通常会合办一些活动跟大家分享。
And one of them is probably you've already know that is G0V. It is an organization that is promoting CVTech and therefore a lot ofInternational communities, they will come to visit us and work with G0V as well.
好，那所以我想我们今天就准备开始。那我们先欢迎这个法国在台协会的这个 Nicola 主任来跟我们致辞。
Now let us welcome Nicola to give an opening remark for us.
Thank you very much. Thank you and.Very happy to be here with you another time. We now regularly have these meetings and discussions. All this cooperation started in 2015 with Thierry Young, with Audrey, with all the community. We started to really help you build strong ties with friends and help these civic tech communities in France and Taiwan know each other better.So this time we once again have the opportunity to welcome two very interesting guests, Jean-Philippe Clément from Paris City Government and Dominique Cardon, for them to discover, for them first to learn, because what we like is when we bring guests and first they learn and they come because they want to learn and discover and build strong ties with you. So that's what they did for 2 days, and they are very excited about what they've seen. We have keeping.We have talked about Taiwan a lot, and now they can experience it firsthand, and I think it's always very important. And it's also time to share and discuss together, so we are very happy about that. This time it is a little bit different. Maybe I can ask Vincent to come. Vincent Manot, he is... Oh, sorry. 不好意思。
这一次很开心，就是我们跟这一次有合作。那其实从2015年了以来，我们就一直跟台湾这边有很多的合作，包括像唐凤委员，还有就是我们 CRO 高这边，我们都有很密切的合作。那这一次其实我们很荣幸邀请到像是 Clément 跟Gardon一起来跟我们分享，在这两天我们一起来学习，一起来那个互相连结。那我们也非常，我们之前一直谈到说，哎，台湾也非常的期待，很开心能够来台湾这边，终于见到这边。那这一次会稍微不一样的部分。
So Vincent Manot is from Institut Français in Paris. Institut Français has been helping us since 2015 to do all these exchanges. This time it's organizing not only a French-Taiwanese exchange but a regional exchange. I let Vincent explain.
Yeah, thank you, Nicola.
那个这一次非常 就是过去以来他一直在帮忙，就是在法国还有就是台湾这边的一些改革的部分，还有巴黎的部分。那接下来就是交由他来致辞。
Good afternoon to everyone. I'm from the Institut Français, the French Institute, which is a French agency of the French Ministry of Foreign Affairs in charge of the promotion of French culture abroad.
那大家好，我是跟法国这边外交事务相关的一个这边，然后一直在负责在这边的外交的相关的事务。
And just like Nicolas said, this is today is the last step of a series of events that have been organized with a wide range of Japanese, Taiwanese, and Korean institutions about the use of data, helping Jean-Philippe Clément and Dominique Cardon to have a lot of meetings and talks about these issues.
那我们之前我一直在跟像是日本、台湾和韩国这边有合作，然后探讨很多，包含像我们这边 Clément这边有很多的一些交流的部分。
And well, we are delighted that the last step of this the series of events is organized here in Taipei for at least two reasons. First, because Taiwan, Taipei is widely known in France for the vitality of its civil society.
那很开心在这一系列的活动的后面，我们来到台北这边来，是因为我们在法国这边其实都知道说台湾跟台北这边是以非常友善的一个城市闻名。
And the debate that is held today is typically the kind of exchanges we want to promote, helping associations, NGO, citizens to discuss the changes on digital changes, environmental issues, and the future of democracy.
那很荣幸能够再跟大家去交流关于像是 NGO 这边的，还有环境的部分，还有数位科技的变革的部分。
And secondly, because Taipei is also one of the most exciting places on earth about the development of civic tech.
那另外一个的话就是台北这边我们也是像公民科技这样子应用的一个开发的场域。
So I'd like to thank once again Audrey Tang, who has been instrumental, I know, about all the meetings that were organized in the last 2 days, and I know he is a good partner of the French office in Taipei.
那也很感谢说在过去两天来我们这样子合作的和交流，那也非常感谢我们的合作伙伴法国在台协会。
So I won't be too long. Just again, thank you for the warm welcome that has been of the Taiwanese people and the Taiwanese institutions during these last 3 days, and have a good debate.
那最后再感谢这过去两天来我们台湾这边的组织还有台湾的民众跟我们非常热烈的欢迎跟热情的欢迎这样子。那希望大家后续顺利成功。
好，那么稍微跟各位说明一下今天的流程我们先会有四位的讲者各自分享大概十分钟的时间。
First, we have sharing sessions from four speakers today. Each will have 10 minutes individually.
那我其实事前有请他们，就是尽量用讲故事或者是讲 case study 的方式，然后看看中间有什么可以就是交集的，这样会让后面的讨论更精彩。
Prior to the sharing, I've been told speakers to use more storytelling and case studies so that it will be more fascinating.
好，那我们同时有这个线上提问的这个平台，你可以到 slido.com 打今天的日期，就是20804021，那可以直接在上面提问。那我们在后面座谈跟 Q&A 的时间呢，就可以从上面先进行。
And also we have online Q&A form, which is, you can see, it's 2018-04-21. You can submit your question there, and then we can make the flow more smoother.
Okay, 最后最重要的呢是这个 OCF 思考大家的捐款可以继续的运作的，所以各位如果喜欢这样系列的活动呢，可以在这个 OCF.TW 的网站上支持我们。
And last but not the least, because OCF is funded by all the people. If you want to support us and see more events like this, please support us with the link on the screen.
好，那我们就来欢迎我们第一位的讲者是 Jean Flynn， 他是从法国巴黎的CDO， 也就是首席算是资料长，好，那同时也负责这边智慧城市的一些政策跟执行，好，那我想今天他会带来非常精彩巴黎的一些经验，欢迎他。
First。